Hey, what's up guys, Benny here, and welcome to another Call of Duty Warzone video, where we're going to be taking a look at Warzone's best assault rifle loadouts for the upcoming season. Now, after I did my ranking top 10 guns from worst to best video in Call of Duty Warzone, a lot of you mentioned the Ram 7, which I had completely overlooked as it was a season 1 weapon unlock. But after using it for a couple of days, it has definitely made its way into my loadouts, along with some other incredible assault rifle setups that you're going to want to use to win more games of Call of Duty Warzone. Oh yeah, and 96.7% of you watching this video are not subscribed to the channel, so if you are new, make sure to subscribe and you'll win your next game of Warzone. I promise. So the first loadout we're going to be taking a look at is the Growl 556. Now, the Growl has definitely been looked at as one of the most overpowered assault rifles within Warzone so far, partially because it's one of the most effective ARs at range with higher range damage, along with recoil that's very easy to control, with recoil just kicking slightly up and to the right. Now, there are a few things to remember with the Growl. It's most effective at ranges up to 60 meters. The second you start getting to fire any further than 60 meters with the Growl, it's just not that effective and has around the fifth slowest time to kill out of all the guns in Warzone. So in order to get the most out of it, you need to be making sure that enemies are within 60 meters of you, as against a good player, you're going to end up losing that fight if they've got an M4A1, for example. So the setup that I would recommend using, which has changed since my last loadout video, is the Monolithic Suppressor, as it's going to increase your gun's damage range and also make your gun suppressed, which is so important in Warzone. And then use the Archangel Barrel, as it not only once again increases your damage range, bullet velocity, and recoil control, it also gives you a super clean iron sight, which means that you don't need to use an optic on this weapon, so you gain an extra attachment effectively. I then have the Commando Foregrip, which is one of the best underbarrels in the game, increasing recoil stabilization and aiming stability. Then you'll want the 60 round magazine, and then the XRK Void 2 rear grip, which counters the negatives from the Archangel Barrel, which is especially helpful towards endgame. So that's the way you should set up your Growl, but then you really have two loadout options to complete the setup. You can pair it with a sniper or use my overpowered loadout with an RPG. I personally would recommend having the RPG setup because it allows you to have cold-blooded, ghost, and amped as your perks the second you use a loadout crate. You'll then want to use C4 and a heartbeat sensor as your lethal and tactical. Overall, the Growl is a very easy weapon to learn and master, though doesn't have the fastest time to kill out of all the assault rifles, so in an even matchup, you could lose out. But in those medium range gunfights, you're going to end up coming out on top with this loadout. Now, my second best loadout in Call of Duty Warzone has come about because of you guys telling me to try it out down in the comments, so a big, big thank you for that, and that is my Ram 7 loadout. Now, from my experience using the gun already, it behaves a lot like the M4A1 with a very, very quick time to kill when in those close range gunfights. So places like downtown and military base, which is where I was finding the Ram 7 to perform extremely well. It does struggle a little bit more at range compared to the M4, so when you're getting into gunfights, you've got to really keep that in mind. And I think that's down to the recoil, which is a bit more hard to manage, but I just can't believe I hadn't used this gun more before. So first of all, on the Ram 7, this is the best class setup for it. You want to use the Monolithic Suppressor, the XRK Ranger Barrel, which increases your damage range, bullet velocity, and recoil control. You then want the Commando Foregrip Underbarrel, the 50 round mag, and then the Stippled Grip Tape. It really is an amazing gun and could potentially go into my top 3. But because in Warzone, you do get into a lot of medium to long range gunfights, I think it is important to pair the Ram with a sniper rifle, as it'll help you get out of a lot of sticky situations. I'd recommend the HDR with Monolithic Suppressor, 26.9 HDR Pro Barrel, the Merc Thermal Optic, the FTAC Stalker Scout Stock, and then the Focus Perk. This loadout is a powerful combination of weapons that will help you perform well in all situations that you'll find yourself in when playing Call of Duty Warzone. The Ram 7 definitely does have a harder skill curve to master compared to some of the other assault rifles in this video because of the more varied recoil, especially at range. But those cons are outweighed by its incredibly fast time to kill in those close range encounters, which you'll be thankful for when it comes to the end circle. My next assault rifle loadout is everyone's favorite AR. Ever since Modern Warfare first came out, the M4A1 has been held in the highest regards, partially because it's a really well-balanced, jack-of-all-trades gun that can perform well in almost every situation that you can come across in Warzone. Pair that with the right setup and you've got a deadly combination that not many weapons can stand up to. Now, what also makes the M4A1 so good is the fact that it's also super easy to use. There's very little recoil, it's got a clean iron sight, and you can just put this gun into anyone's hands and they're going to be able to hold their own. Now, out of all the assault rifles, it's got a pretty mid ranking when it comes to time to kill speeds. But as I mentioned earlier, it's how reliable and consistent the M4 is that makes it such a great weapon to use, which you'll already probably know from either just using it yourself or being killed by one. So for those of you that are also wanting to master the recoil pattern, by standard, it tends to kick to the right a bit and then up. Now, there's two builds that I use for the M4A1, which you might want to try out, which I think are the best setups. The first build includes the Molotovic Suppressor. This is an attachment that you're going to end up using on pretty much every single gun within Warzone as a heads up. Then you want the stock M16 Grenadier Barrel, which gives you increased damage range, bullet velocity, and recoil control. I then have the Forged Tac CQS stock, which gives you that faster aim down sight speed, with Stipple Grip Tape also increasing your aim down sight speed and sprint to fire speed, which is crucial with the fast-paced nature of Warzone. I then have the 60-round mag to help make sure that I can take down entire squads in close quarters without needing to reload. Then my second setup for the M4A1 is technically the best loadout stat-wise, includes the Monolithic Suppressor, the M16 Grenadier Barrel, the no-stock attachment, then the Commando Foregrip and 60-round extended mag. Either of those two loadouts will do you well. Try them out and see what works best for you. Then for the rest of the class, I'll tend to run the RPG with Cold-Blooded, Ghost, and Amped as my perks, with either Semtexes or C4 for my lethal, and then that ever-present heartbeat sensor for my tactical. If you're new to Call of Duty Warzone, this is probably the gun that I would recommend to use, just because of how well-rounded it is. ARs like the Ram 7 are going to win at close range, the Grau at 60 meters, but the M4 can be really solid within all those ranges, so will probably, in the long run, be the gun that helps you have the highest kill-death ratio. My next assault rifle loadout involves the assault rifle, which I think is definitely overlooked, but is actually really strong, especially against players that are fully plated, because of how quickly it can take down a fully armored player, especially if you're landing your headshots, and that's the M13. One thing to be aware of with the M13 is that it has very little recoil, but if you're landing body shots only, it doesn't have that fast of a time to kill. But what it does have is an incredible headshot multiplier, which can make it one of the best guns in the game because of how low its recoil is and how high its rate of fire is, but does require you to be very, very accurate to get the most out of it. For example, you can take out an enemy that's fully armored in just 7 bullets with the M13, which when you think about the gun's fire rate, is insane. The M13 is also amazing at ranged gunfights, so outperforms weapons like the M4A1, Ram 7, and the Grau in those gunfights above 60 meters, which does happen a lot in Warzone. Now, the setup that I use includes, surprisingly, the Monolithic Suppressor, the Tempest Marksman Barrel, the TAC Laser, which for those asking, just gives your gun so many benefits, and because it only appears when you ADS and the Warzone map is so large, it rarely gets spotted. If they bring a nighttime version of the map out, that'll be a different story and you probably won't want to use the TAC Laser, but otherwise, it's really good. Then you want Stippled Grip Tape for that faster aim down sight time, and then the 60-round magazine to finish up the build. If you want to mix things up a bit, definitely try out the M13. For newer players and players that aren't as confident in their aim, I'd probably stick with the Grau or the M4, which don't require you to land headshots as much. Then, as always, I'd probably pair the M13 with an RPG, just because having that 3-perk setup, including Cold-Blooded, Ghost and Amped right at the start of a game is so, so powerful, along with C4 Semtexes and the Heartbeat Sensor. And that's a pretty great assault rifle loadout. Now, in Call of Duty Warzone, those four assault rifles, the Ram 7, the M4A1, the Grau, and the M13, are the four best that you can use in the game. I'd personally recommend avoiding using the FR556, the Odin, SCAR, and AK-47 on your custom loadouts, as they just don't perform as consistently well. Then with those three assault rifles, either pair it with the RPG loadout that I've already shown you so much, the sniper class, which includes a HDR with monolithic suppressor, 26.9 HDR Pro barrel, the Merc Thermal Optic, the F-TAC Stalker Scout stock, and the Focus perk. Though if you use this, remember to always swap out with a second loadout in a game and pick your sniper back off the floor to get the Ghost perk. In those end circles, it's going to be the difference between winning and losing. Then the final setup I tend to use with my assault rifle is pairing it with an SMG like the MP7, with the monolithic suppressor, the recon barrel, tac laser, commando foregrip, and the 60 round magazine. I wouldn't personally use this with the Ram, as the Ram is really good at close range, but the M4, M13, and Grau, it's a really good pairing, so you can dominate at close range as well. Oh, and if you do want to take a screenshot to remind you of my assault rifle builds, I'll quickly put them all on screen so you can save them. And if you can, please do share your own best assault rifle loadouts down in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel so you win your next game of Warzone, and smash that like button, and I'll see you next time.